we have come to the last plugin of the Nik Collection, which is HDR FX Pro. I have opened Room Inside. The image we see here has been made in HDR FX Pro. It is built up from several images. As we can see, in this image, both the inside and the outside are well lit. However, if we look at the original images, we see the camera originally wasn't able to shoot this. When I set the camera to have the inside well lit, the outside is blown out. And when I focus the camera on having the outside well lit, the inside becomes too dark. The reason for this is that our eyes are about twice as flexible as a camera. This means our eyes are able to see a wider range of very dark up until very light colors than a camera can. Normally, this isn't a problem and isn't noticeable. But in some situations, for example, with a bright sun in the background, combined with large shadow areas, in these situations, the lower dynamic range of the camera can become visible. The deepest blacks, up until the lightest lights, now can't be captured by the camera all at the same time. So if you want, in an HDR or high dynamic range situation, to create an image that exactly shows what you see with your eyes, you have to make more than one picture. A darker picture and a lighter picture. Then you combine these images with a special HDR program. When you make more than one picture of the same scene, you will need a tripod to make sure the camera doesn't move between making the dark and the light picture. If you don't have a tripod, or you have only one image from a scene, you can still open a single image in HDR FX to improve it. You will get better results though using different images. When you open a single image, it's best to open a darker image, so without blown out highlights. I go to Filters, Google Nik Collection, and choose HDR FX Pro. I have now opened a single image. With the default settings, the image already improved. To go through the different settings of HDR FX and see the entire process of HDR creation, I will now open different images of the scene. The opening of multiple images goes via the plugin itself. I go to File, Open Images. Although you can create an HDR image with just two images, HDR programs prefer a minimum of three images. So with an extra neutral image in between the dark and the light image, I hold the Control key pressed down and select Room Dark, Room Medium, and Room Light. In the Merge dialog window, it is recommended to align the images and to have the program remove color artifacts by selecting these options. And at the top, you can choose which image will be the ghost reference image. The ghost reference image determines where an object will be visible when that object has moved between shooting the images. And at the bottom, you can adjust the relative influence of the images. I will leave it as it is, so equally divided. I click on Create HDR. Under Tonality, I can adjust the exposure, so I can make the image darker or lighter. I will make it a bit lighter. I can also adjust the shadows and highlights individually. Under it, I can adjust the contrast. Here, I can also adjust the contrast in the darker areas and the lighter areas separately. I think I have enough structure in my image, but you can adjust it if you want to. Tone compression brings tones closer to each other. Moving the slider to the right makes the light tones darker and the dark tones lighter. Method strength determines how strong the settings under HDR method are applied. Right now, depth is set to normal. I can increase it to strong or decrease it to subtle. Or I can choose not to use depth. Detail is by default on realistic. I can make the detail softer and going to the right, I make it stronger. Drama provides different ways of bringing more drama to an image. Under color, you can adjust saturation, color temperature, and tint. I will warm the image up a bit. Tint in conjunction with temperature is often used in programs as Lightroom to color correct an image. Under selective adjustments, you can place control points to add masks. And under finishing, you have the graduated neutral density filter. If you have, for example, a landscape image where the top of the image is still too light, you can darken the top of the image without darkening the rest of the image. If I drag upper tonality to the left, I darken the top of the image. I can also darken or lighten the lower part of the image with lower tonality. With blend, I can make the transition area smaller or larger. With vertical shift, I can move the transition up or down, making the top area or lower area larger. And with rotation, I can rotate the filter. In color effects, there are several graduated neutral density filters you can use. Everything you make in HDR effects, whether it's coming from multiple images or from a single image opened via GIMP, you have to save via the plugin. So I go to File, Save Image As. Clicking the Save button at the bottom will only return the file, so without any changes. I go to File, Save Image As and give the file a name. I can save the file as a JPEG or a TIFF. The TIFF format gives the best image quality, so I will choose TIFF. In GIMP, I will now open the result. In the next chapter, we will look at retouching.